Dit is Papa Alpha 0 Echo Tango Echo voor de Daily Minutes met een nieuwsupdate voor vandaag 7 november 2015. Dit is het bulletin van zaterdag. Onze uitzendingen in het weekend zijn altijd in het Engels. Aan het eind van de uitzending een kort stukje en een heel andere datum wordt dus dan we de afgelopen week hebben getest. QPSK 250. QPSK 250 rond 700 hertz. 700 hertz. De komende dagen gaan we weer door met de tests met Contestia tijdens de uitzending. Today's bulletin, as every weekend, is in English. At the end of the broadcast, we have some data, which is a diversion from what we did the last couple of days. QPSK 250, centered around 700 Hz. QPSK 250, centered around 700 Hz. Today was the day of the yearly Day of the Radio Amateur, the biggest ham radio event in the Netherlands. We start today with the propagation bulletin of the RSGB.
CQ, 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 calling all radio amateurs and shortwave listeners. This is GB2RS, the news broadcasting service of the Radio Society of Great Britain. It comes to you from G4NJH in Nottingham. Now for the radio propagation report, compiled by G0KYA, G4BAO and G3YLA. This week saw a perfect example of how the sun affects HF propagation. As we predicted last week, a high-speed solar wind stream hit the Earth on Tuesday. This pushed the K-index to 5, as the incoming plasma had a south-facing BZ field that enabled it to more easily couple to the Earth's magnetic field. The result was that in the afternoon of Tuesday the 3rd, 10 meters was alive with signals during the initial positive phase of the subsequent geomagnetic storm. Stations from Columbia and the Falklands were very strong, as the maximum usable frequency headed past 40 megs on southerly paths. Even stations in Belgium could be heard via backscatter on 28 megs. By Wednesday, the incoming solar wind was still fierce at 750 kilometers per second. The noon critical frequency, as measured by the Chilton ionosonde, was 10.15 megs, giving a predicted maximum usable frequency over a 3,000 kilometer path of 36 megs and pushing the K-index to 5. Usually, the secondary phase of a geomagnetic storm sees critical frequencies plummet, but that didn't seem to happen with this event. Next week, NOAA predicts that the solar flux index will be in the range of 110 to 125 with a continued risk of geomagnetic disturbances, especially on the 13th and 14th. This season still remains a good time to be on HF. Now for VHF and up, with some very good tropospheric conditions still fresh in our memory from last weekend, it's probably going to be the complete opposite for a while. Deep lows will pass by the far northwest and produce generally windy conditions across much of the country in the coming week. There is, however, a possibility of high pressure over the continent, which may just lift conditions over the south of England at times in the second half of the week. This may connect the southernmost counties into what will probably be some very good tropo within Europe. For meteor scatter enthusiasts, the Taurids meteor shower, which has a broad peak from the 5th to the 12th of November, may provide some large fireballs and long, strong trails. For EME operators, declination is now negative, reaching its lowest next Saturday, meaning short windows with increasing losses as the moon reaches apogee, its furthest point away from Earth on Sunday. That's it from the propagation team for this week. On the 4th of November, the inaugural launch of an experimental US military vehicle carrying several satellites with amateur radio payloads failed in mid-flight shortly after taking off at 0345 UTC from Hawaii. Destroyed in the demonstration flight were 13 small research spacecraft clustered on the mission for NASA researchers and university students. None of the satellites carried amateur radio transponders, but several were equipped to transmit beacon signals and telemetry on 2 meter 70 sems and 13 sems amateur frequencies. Several Dutch stations have appeared on the 5 MHz band in the erroneous assumption that 5 megs has become available in the Netherlands. Well, it hasn't, and it won't be until the middle of November at the earliest. The confusion arose in the way the law is applied in the Netherlands. Following the announcement, the radio amateur frequency tables have to be officially adjusted and published, and this has not yet happened. Until that time, any contacts with Dutch stations on 5 megs are not, in fact, legitimate. On the 2nd of November, the 2015 World Radio Conference opened in Geneva with a record number of 3,800 delegates attending. Amongst many topics is Agenda Item 1.4 regarding a potential global 5-meg amateur allocation, which is facing serious opposition. There are several other items that may affect other amateur and amateur satellite service allocations. Colin Thomas, G3PSM, is attending as part of the UK delegation and is providing process updates via a blog on the RSGB website. IARU volunteers are also present and are under no illusions regarding the challenge and opportunities ahead over the coming weeks until the conference concludes on the 27th of November. Updates from Colin and other background information are at rsgb.org/WRC-15.
Daily Minutes zijn dagelijks om 1900 uur te beluisteren op PI2NOS en 's ochtends om 10:30. Verder zijn de uitzendingen onder andere te beluisteren op youtube.com/PA0ETE.